Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video we are going to continue the bases and subbases. Okay, so in that we have a definition, that is the second countable space. Okay, so let us define this one. So as we have first countable space for a local base, okay, so which depends on the local base. Okay, similarly we have a second countable space which is based on the basis. That is, if there exists a countable base for a topological space, then we say that it is a second countable space. Okay, so that is, let x comma t be a topological space then it is said to be a second countable space if there exists a countable base for T. Okay, suppose if there exists a countable base for T, then we can say that this the given topological space is a second countable space. Okay, now we have a theorem here, or if you want an example, here we have an example. See here, this we have a x equals to a comma b, or we take solved example only. In the last video we have shown that this is a base for this b, forms a base for this t. Okay, this is solved in the last video. Now you can observe that this base here there exists a base for this t, and this base is countable. You can observe that this is a countable base, therefore we can say that this topological space is a countable space, countable, therefore it is a second countable space. Okay, so therefore this topological space is a countable space because there exists base for this T and it is countable base, therefore it is a second countable space. Okay, now we have a theorem here. Every topological space every second countable space is first countable okay. So we have to show that every second countable space is first countable. So that means for every second countable space there exists, we have to show that there exists a local base. Okay, proof. Let x comma t be a second countable space. Then there exists a countable base beta for T. So this is by the definition of second countable space. Okay, as this x comma T is a second countable space, then there exists a base beta for T which is countable. Now to show that x comma t is a first countable, so in order to show that it is a first countable, we must show that we have to show that there exists a local base for each point. Okay, so we must show that for each point, for each x belongs to x, there exists a countable local base. Okay, so now we have to show that it is a there exists a local base. Okay, for this let x belongs to x be an arbitrary element. Okay, then int bx, or you can consider as a beta x, okay, be the family of those members of beta which contains x. So here we are considering x belongs to x be an arbitrary element, and bx is the collection of all those members of beta which contains x. So this bx is a collection of all the subsets of x which belongs to, sorry, which contains x. Okay, now if n is neighborhood of x, then we can write it as, so since this n is a neighborhood of x, by the definition of neighborhood there exists an open set G containing x in beta. Okay, there exists an open set G containing x in beta, which also, okay, and therefore this beta also belongs to, therefore in bx also. Okay, why this in bx? Because this bx is a subset of this beta. Okay, so according to the base there exists a neighborhood containing x in beta. Why this beta? Because this beta is the base for given t. Okay, so therefore since this g exists in this beta, definitely there this g exist in bx also, because it is a collection of all the open set, all the sets which contains x. So therefore we can write it as such that x belongs to g is a subset of, yeah, this is by the definition of neighborhood. So therefore this shows that bx is a local base. So from this we can say that if there exist, for each open set containing x there exists neighborhood which is neighborhood n, such that x belongs to g is subset of n. So according to the definition of local base, we can say that this bx is a local base. Okay, x. Now also bx is subfamily of, it is a subset of countable space. Okay, because it is a subspace of bx, here we write bx, it is a subset of beta, and which beta is a base for t, which is a second countable space, therefore beta, this bx is also countable. Okay, countable family beta, therefore, so it means that bx is subset of beta. Okay, so therefore bx is also countable. So here we have proved that bx is a local base and bx is countable. So therefore we can say that as bx is local base at x and it is countable implies that bx is first countable space. Okay. So therefore, we can say that every second countable space is first countable. But converse is not true. That is, every first countable is not necessarily second countable. Okay. So here we write a remark. Every first countable space not necessarily second countable. Okay. So every second countable space is first countable, but every first countable space is not necessarily second countable space. Okay.